I'm at a new location today for white-throated dippers. I haven't been here before, so it's going to be exciting to see how the lightning is and how the bird behaves at this spot, so stay tuned. This is the little stream the white-throated dipper likes to be in this kind of habitat with the water streaming shallow water with the rocks and stuff like that. That's the habitat they like to be in anyway in Denmark when they are here for winter time. So this spot I found here is quite good because it's quite open, so hopefully I get a lot of light on the stream and on the bird, of course. So really beautiful place. My setup for today is the Sony A1 and the Sony 600mm as I usually bring, and my E-Image tripod set with the GH06 video fluid head and the carbon fiber legs here. It's quite heavy to drag along on a trip like this, but it's fantastic to use and shoot from. It's really stable. Today I'm filming my speak with the DJI Osmo Pocket 2. I used to use the Sony ZV-1, and that's a good camera, but this is way more easy for me to just have in the bag. It's fast to start up, and it's got a really good quality in the sound because this little mic I have here, it's a wireless mic paired up with this little camera, so it's fantastic just to have along on a trip like this. So really excited to see how it looks when I edit this episode. My goal for today was to get some flight shots of the bird. I got some. I'm not sure how good they turned out because the lightning is best in early morning here. As I said before, I haven't been here before, so now we have afternoon lightning and it's kind of dark down by the stream here where I sit. So. But what I do when I try to get flight shots of a bird like this, I know it always flies just above the stream. So what I do, I pre-focus somewhere down the stream, I don't know, 20 meters down, 30 meters maybe, from where I would like to start tracking the bird, so I know it's sharp there and the camera has a easier time to focus on the birds when it comes, because it flies really fast. So that's was my aim for today. I got some birds and flight shots, but I have to see when I get home how good they were, because it was quite dark and the ISO went up a bit. So I think to get a fast bird like this in flight, you have to go to 3200 of a second or higher. I think higher would be better because it flies really fast. So, but the biggest challenge is to get a focus lock on the bird, especially because there's a lot of vegetation all around it. So, but that's where the Sony cam is really strong for what I have used before. I had DSLR before, Nikon. It was really good, but nothing like this. This is a crazy fast autofocus. It's been a while since my last trip. I don't really have the time at the moment to get out, and it's winter time here in Denmark, so when I'm off work, it's dark, and in the morning it's dark when I go to work, so I only have the weekends, and I had a lot of family stuff, good stuff, luckily. So yeah, it's been a while. That's all I had to show today. I hope you enjoyed the episode. Well, hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. Stay safe. Bye.